It's Chris for BBTV. We're at the Forum in Wivenshaw. It's an amateur boxing night, and I'm joined by professional boxer Mario Silva, Super Mario.
Yes, guys. How are you guys? How are you, Chris?
I'm very well. It's good to see you. It's good
to see you too, man. Came down to show some support to the boxers here, lifting up their spirits, giving some advice here, and then watching a good crowd of boxing now. So
yeah. It's nice to see you at the amateur show. I mean, you've had two pro fights now.
Yeah.
I think I've been to a few of your amateur fights as well. Back in them days,
yeah.
Here you are now as a pro boxer. It's nice to come back and see the amateurs and support.
You know what? It's always good to look back to where you came from and show support to the fighters that are coming up as well. So, if anything, me going and showing these kids support is motivating me to keep doing what I'm doing.
Yeah, that's brilliant. And what you're doing, you turned pro, Mario. I was at your debut fight, actually. I'm not sure if I was at your second, but I watched it. You're doing well, two pro fights. I mean, I've known you since you was a young boy.
Yeah,
I know
your
dad. So it's really lovely, I must say, to see you doing so well and to making that step into the pros. So well done. How's it been going? How are you finding it?
You know what? It's been going really good. Nothing but blessings, alhamdulillah. Everything's going great so far. And you guys better keep in watch. I've got big things coming up, big news on the way, and this year is going to be a very good year for me.
Yeah. How's your dad?
My dad's very good,
right.
You know.
Your dad's your trainer, he's a former pro boxer.
Yes, he's doing very good. As we're developing, he's developing as a coach, and new ideas are coming in, and it's absolutely great. The sky's the limits with us.
Mm. Like I said, I've known you for a long time. When I first saw you, you was a young kid. I never thought you was going to be a boxer. I thought you was just at the gym waiting for your dad to finish training the boxes so you could go on. But you've turned into a boxer, a fine young man, and a professional boxer. So it's been great to see that. But what was it about you? You know, because was you always destined to be a boxer, or was something that come to you?
You know
later
what?
On?
At first, I was just around the scene. I've been getting my diapers changed in the gym for years. And it came to me when I moved in with Paulie when I was 15 years old, and we just decided, you know what, I want to take something serious. And as far as I tried getting away from boxing, I've always just kept coming back to it. And I realized, you know what, instead of me trying to run away from my destiny, let me just hit it. And I've come to realize, and I've come to a reflection, that boxing's for me, and boxing's my way to show who I am as a person and achieve the things I want to achieve in life. So boxing is the only way for me.
It must have been always there. It must have been in the blood. You see your dad doing it.
People say that this blood thing about boxing, I think it's true, because the boxing's always been there since day one. Even when I wasn't taking it serious, it's always been there. And now that I'm embracing it and I'm showing people, yo, I'm here and I'm here to stay.
How have you found it? What's it been like, making that decision, but then, doing it, turning pro, and now two fights down the line? How does it feel to be a pro boxer and make that step?
You know what? It feels like home. There's no other word I can say. No nerves, no stress, no backlashes, just blessings. This is home sweet home. This is all I know. When I step in that ring, it feels like I'm at home already. I just embrace and I show people what I'm about. If anything, it's been very welcoming pro boxing, and people are gonna see how comfortable I am in the ring and show that all I bring to the table is class, and that's what people are gonna see this year from me, especially, inshallah.
And what about your dad? What was your dad's initial reaction when you said you wanted to be a pro? Did it take a lot of persuading him, a lot of showing him that you was dedicated to the cause? Because Paulie's I know Paulie well, I've told you, and he likes his fighters to train hard. He's quite diligent in what he does. Did you have to pass a certain criteria before he'd let you make that decision and turn pro, knowing he knows how hard the game is?
What my dad wanted to see, he wanted to see consistency. Consistency of having good fights, and when it comes to consistency with mindset. And after my last amateur fight and I won, and under the circumstances and situation I was in, it proved to him that I was ready for the next step. And that opened Paulie's eyes to go, yo, this kid's ready. And I was telling him, listen, Paulie, as much as preparation is key, and you know my daddy's well preserved when it comes to taking his time and working our way up, he's seen something in my eyes that he thought, you know what, this kid's ready. And I'm glad that he believed in me, and now we took this step, and now the world's going to see what we're about.
Yeah. And he's doing his own thing in the gym as well, isn't he? He's got a few boxers under his wing, so you've got a good team around you as well now.
Very good team.
Tell us about the team and how it works and how you fit into that.
My circle, you've got Khalil Majid, you've got Tank, who's a heavyweight, you've got Duke Scott, you've got James Mash. There's so many fighters coming through now. You've got Tyrell. There's so many fighters, even though they're amateur and they train with us pros, me training with them, this is my circle. These are the people I see every morning. And our circle is so strong. And when I see them working hard, it pushes me to work hard. And it's not just the boxing, it's outside the boxing, our mindset towards everything. And it pushes us to be not just good boxers, but good people. So the circle we got in the gym, everyone's uplifting everyone at all times. So it's priceless and it's speechless. I can't even get the words out when it comes to the point of how blessed everyone in the gym is, and everyone's opportunities is, we can't even put a mark on people's gaps when it comes into the gym. Everyone's destined for greatness. It's just, we got to keep doing what we're doing, keep believing in it, working hard, and it's going to happen.
So you've got everything there in place, the platform for you to really accelerate and go far. Yeah. Tell us about the first two fights, how you performed and what you've learned from them.
My first fight, I realised that I can take my time and I can really showcase my skills, and that's what I wanted to do from the start, because in amateur, it's all about just getting out there because you only got 2 minutes. But since I turned over, I feel like I can actually showcase my skills and showcase my ring IQ to people. And even on my second fight, I showed that I'm a tough fighter. I can go in with anybody, especially you, Harley Ben. I can go in with anybody. And people really see that from me. And even though people may doubt me or see little things in me and think, oh, I can get in this kid, I can get it. I always show a new skill of fighting, and people are going to see the definition of boxing when I start stepping up.
Mm. Harley Ben, what's the thing going on there?
You know what? We're on IG Live, yeah? And he was supposed to come down for sparring with Lyndon. And then my name got thrown about. And I can get him preparation when it comes to sparring. I'll give him good spars. And you know what? If he don't want the spar, that's perfectly fine. He knows where I'm at in Manchester. He knows how to come up here. He knows what gym I train at. So whenever he wants to spar, we're ready for it. Any man can get it.
Someone else told me that's about Lyndon and I don't know what's going on. You'll have to enlighten me.
You know what? It's just a bit. It's just a bit of.
Sorry, but I mean, Lyndon's like, anyway, he's not going to fight.
It's all about. So it's all this sparring and going back and forth. But you know what? It just shows if we can have talks with these guys and be in the same field as these guys, and these guys don't even want to come down for sparring, it just shows where we're at when it comes to the boxing side and how people are trying to duck us already.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you're looking to push on. When's your next fight?
My next fight is February 18th in Bowlers Arena on the Black Flash show.
Lovely. Okay, Bowlers on Pat's show at the Bowlers. Yeah, so back at the Bowlers for Black Flash. Again, you just want to get a good opponent. Again, third fight on the way, and again another progressive step.
This year it's all about building myself up. Like, you know, the end goal is to become the first Portuguese fighter to become a world champion, and I'm going to do it, inshallah. It's all about building myself up as a fighter, and like I said in previous interviews, I'm not no average pro, I'm an elite fighter, and I'm here to show that.
Mm-hmm. That's right, your dad's from Portugal, Paulie, isn't he? Were you born in Manchester, weren't you?
No, I was born in Portugal.
Was you born in Portugal?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay.
That's why I'm trying to put my city back on the map, because there's not been a Portuguese fighter who fought for the world title since 1925 called Santo Camarão, and he lost. And there's never once been a Portuguese fighter who's actually became a world champion. But you're looking at him right now. I'm going to be there, inshallah. Wow. And I'm going to show everyone that I'm here and I can achieve these things. It's not just words. So I'm going to prove that with my actions.
That would be a great thing to do, wouldn't it? Yeah. How often do you go over to Portugal? And you got a lot of family haven't you?
I go pretty much every year. I show love to everyone over there. That's my bread and butter. But obviously, my bread and butter comes from Manchester as well. There's no better place than Manchester.
Yeah. Well, I'll vouch for that one. But yeah, we might have Portugal's first world champion on our hands.
Definitely will.
Manchester. We won't forget his Mancunian about as well.
Definitely won't.
It's great to see you, young man. I'll tell you what, it makes me feel old knowing how big and professional you're getting now. But
it's because you see me from such a young age build up, and from just being, he could be a good pro, now it's here. And time flew. Mm. And now I can't wait till I'm 28, 29, and I'm 30 and 0, and we're seeing what's going on with the boxing scene then.
I wish you all the very best.
Appreciate that so much.
He's a very good young man, nice young man, very polite. Every time I see you over the years, you've always been a lovely young kid.
Well.
He certainly has, and I really hope and I wish and I'd love to see you do really well, Mario. So God bless you.
God bless you too, brother.
And it's love to see you. Say hello to your dad.
I will do, brother.